In this video, we will take a very broad overview of how the entire human body works. I can start listing the functions of different organ systems right away. But that would be boring. A more interesting way to understand it is in line with how life evolved to be in its present form. So we will go with that. Life started as a unicellular organism. In this form, it took all the nutrients like food and oxygen directly from its external surrounding. It metabolized them to use them. And then released the waste products directly back into the external environment. Now, the problem with the unicellular form was that it needed to do all the work on its own. And also, it was very vulnerable to the hostile environment. As a solution, multiple cells started teaming up, forming a multicellular organism. And eventually, life evolved into what we are today, over the period of millions of years. Now let's understand what happened during all these years in a simplified way. First of all, the cells built a home made up of skin, separating themselves from the external environment. The environment inside this home is called the internal environment of the body. Now the cells do not have to worry much about the external environment. They just need a comfortable internal environment. And all the cells in the body contribute to this. The collective job of all the cells is to keep the internal environment suitable for life. For example, it should have enough nutrients so all the cells in the body can get them easily. And also, the cells release their waste products into this internal environment. So it needs to be cleaned from these waste products regularly. Similarly, there are so many things to be taken care of inside this home. This maintenance of this home is called homeostasis. For this, the cells created different teams and started specializing in their work. Eventually, this resulted in the development of different organ systems. Each organ system performs special functions that ultimately contribute to keeping the internal environment suitable for cell survival. Please note that this diagram is to explain the functional organization. So please ignore the actual anatomy for now. Moving back to the role of these organ systems, the musculoskeletal system helps move the entire body to grab the food in the external environment. The digestive system takes in this food, digests it, and brings in nutrients like carbohydrates, fatty acids, amino acids, etc., from the external environment into the internal environment. Respiratory system brings in the oxygen. The cardiovascular system stirs the internal environment so that these nutrients reach all the cells inside the body. The cell, as usual, uses these nutrients to perform its functions and release the waste products back into the internal environment. The urinary system removes these waste products from the internal environment. The respiratory system and liver also help in the cleanup process. The respiratory system removes carbon dioxide, and the liver detoxifies or removes drugs and chemicals ingested in the body. Now, although these systems have specialized in whatever they do, they cannot work independently or haphazardly. Their activity must be coordinated and regulated based on the requirement of the internal as well as external conditions. For example, if a person needs to chase a chicken to get it as food, mainly it will be the duty of the musculoskeletal system. But it cannot do so alone. Along with muscles, the respiratory system also needs to work harder to get more oxygen for muscles. And the circulatory system also needs to speed up to deliver nutrients to the muscle. Thus, the activity of different organ systems needs to be coordinated and regulated. And that is the job of the nervous system and endocrine system. They detect changing conditions and regulate the activity of the organs as needed for those changes. There are also defense systems to protect the internal environment from external threats. The integumentary system is the first line of defense. It's a strong wall between the internal and external environment, preventing entry of most of the harmful things in the body. But some naughty things do find their way inside the body. And for them, we have the immune system as the second line of defense. It identifies foreign cells and substances and destroys them. Finally, we have a reproductive system. Although reproduction is not a homeostatic function for an individual, it helps maintain life by generating new beings who replace those who die. So this is an overview of how the human body works. Again, this is a conceptual understanding, and things get more and more complex as we go deeper and deeper. But I hope this schematic explanation has made your fundamentals clear. That's it for this video. You can find notes and explore our entire animation video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe, because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.